Now, we will start with the Paleozoic era, the last period, Permian. We have completed our 5 periods. Now, the Permian period started around 230 million years ago, and the climatic conditions were, the continents were now started to form, and the climatic conditions were varied, that is more and more type of variations in the climates were started at this time, and the plant life was decline of the bryophytes. The bryophytes which has been appeared in the Ordovician period, that has been now declined. The bryophytes are now getting extincted. The animal life dominance and the extinction of the trilobites means that the trilobites, that is the insects, or we can call this as arthropods. Arthropods started to rise in the Carboniferous period, and in the beginning of the Permian period they were in the dominance, and at the end of the Permian period they got extincted. So this is the dominance and the extinction of the trilobites in the same period of the era. And the second one, abundance of the primitive reptiles. Now the reptiles were also being abundant, they have started to rise, and now they will be abundant in the Permian era. Now the next era, in the Permian period. Now the next era is the Mesozoic era. In this, the first one is the Triassic. The Triassic era has been was around 206 million years ago, and now the continents started to exposed. Now the continents were being named, and when we talk about the plant life, the gymnosperms were dominant at this time, and the extinction of the ferns. The ferns were extincted and the gymnosperms were dominant in this time. And when we talk about the animal life, the origin of giant dinosaurs. The reptiles were dominant in the Permian period. Now the dominance of the dinosaurs started, that is dinosaurs increased their number, therefore they become dominant in the Triassic period of the Mesozoic era. And the origin of Prototherian mammals. Prototherian mammals also started originating in the Triassic era of the Mesozoic period. Here there is one thing to remember, that the mammals also started originating along with the lineage of reptiles. That is, when the reptiles weren't dominant, at that time only the mammals were started to origin. Mammals started to have their origin. So when the dinosaurs were in their dominant form, at that time the Prototherian mammals were evolved. And in the Jurassic period, this is the period of dinosaurs. We all know very well that Jurassic period is the period of dinosaur. It was around 165 million years ago, and the climatic conditions were quite normal, that is quite warm, not so cold and not so hot. And the plant life, cycads and conifers. Conifers mean the pinuses, that is cycads and the conifers were common. And here in the Jurassic period, the first angiosperms, the first plant, flowering plant were arises in the Jurassic period. And here the dominance of dinosaurs and the appearance of first tooth bird. What was the first tooth bird? Archaeopteryx, which is also the connecting link between the reptiles and the birds. So in the Jurassic period, dinosaurs were also in their dominant. The first tooth bird, that is Archaeopteryx, were also appeared in the Jurassic period, and the reptiles were also diversified, and they were also spread all over the world. And the Metatherian mammals were also been originated only in the Jurassic period. So remember this period, because the characteristics of this period, that what was the plant life and what was the animal life. It is the only period when the flowering plant was originated first, and it is the only period when the dinosaurs were dominant, and there was the diversification of the reptiles. First tooth bird, that is Archaeopteryx, has been originated, and metatherian mammals were also being originated in the Jurassic period. The last one, or the last period of the Mesozoic era, is the Cretaceous. It was around 135 million years ago, and the climatic conditions were very diverse. Now the climate also started their diversification. Variations in the climates were seen in the Cretaceous period, and the rise of the flowering plant. Now the angiosperms have been originated in the Jurassic period. Now they will rise and they will diversified their they will become diversified, and they will show the variations in the later on periods. And when we talk about the animal life, dinosaurs reached to their peak. Dinosaurs were now very much dominant. They reached to their peak of development. Now they will become extinct. At the early stage of this period, early stage of the period Cretaceous, dinosaurs were in the dominance. They were at their peak. And by the end of the Cretaceous period, dinosaurs were become extincted. And the extinction of the tooth bird, that is Archaeopteryx, were extincted in the Cretaceous period. And the beginning of the telost fishes, meaning beginning of now the bony fishes. The bony fishes now been appeared in the Cretaceous period. The golden age of fishes was Devonian. At that time the diversification of the fishes started. Some sharks were also being originated, and the lung fishes were also originated in the Devonian period of the Paleozoic era. Now the bony fishes have been appeared in the Cretaceous period of the Mesozoic era. So remember this point, that beginning of the telost fishes or the bony fishes was in the Cretaceous period. And the origin of eutherian mammals. Eutherian mammals were originated in the Mesozoic era, in the last period, that is Cretaceous. So what we have studied, the Permian period, of the last period of the Paleozoic era, it was around 230 million years ago, and it is the era when the bryophytes were declined, and the dominance of the and the dominance and extinction of trilobites have also seen in the Permian period, and abundance of the primitive reptiles in the previous one. That is, in the Carboniferous one, reptiles were arised in that period. Now the reptiles become dominant in this, reptiles become somewhat dominant. That is, they increase their number in the Permian period. And the next era is the Mesozoic era. The first period of the Mesozoic era is Triassic period, which was around 206 million years ago. And the things to remember in this is that gymnosperms become dominant and the ferns were extincted up to this period. Gymnosperms dominated and ferns were extincted up to this period. And this is the period of origin of giant reptiles, that is the dinosaurs. Origin of giant reptiles and the origin of prototherian mammals. The first mammals has been evolved, or the origin of the first mammal was along with the abundance of the reptiles. Now the second period, that is the Jurassic, it is the period of the dominance of dinosaurs. It is the age of dinosaurs, we can say that. So it was around 165 million years ago, and here the first flowering plant or the first angiosperms were originated, and also it is the period of the diversification of the dinosaurs. Dinosaurs diversified at this time, and secondly the tooth bird, that is the Archaeopteryx, were also have been originated at this time, and the spread of the reptiles. Reptiles were totally spreaded, and they were totally diversified all over the world. And the mammals were metatherian mammals, has been evolved along with the diversification of the reptiles. Now the third one, that is Cretaceous, it was around 135 million years ago. And here when we talk about the plant life, the angiosperms were started rising. Angiosperms increase their number. They were now started to become dominant. And when we talk about the animal life, dinosaurs were at their peak in the starting of the Cretaceous period, and at the end of the Cretaceous period they were also being extincted. And the tooth bird, that is the Archaeopteryx, which was evolved in the Jurassic period, that are now also being extincted. The Archaeopteryx are extincted in the Cretaceous period, which is the connecting link between the reptiles and the birds. And it is the beginning of the origin of telosed fishes, that is of the bony fishes. Actually, the fishes were evolved in the Devonian period of the Paleozoic era, but at that time there was no origin of the bony fishes. The bony fishes has been originated in the Cretaceous period of the Mesozoic era, and along with this there is the origin of Eutherian mammals. So now up to here we have completed our Mesozoic era also. Now we will study about the last era, that is Cenozoic era. So here it is the last era of the geological time scale. This last era has been divided into two periods, tertiary and quaternary. The tertiary is also known as Paleogene and the quaternary is known as Neogene. Now, the tertiary period has been further divided into epochs. The first epoch is Paleocene, second Eocene, Oligocene, Miocene and Pliocene. These are the epochs of the first period, that is of tertiary period, and of the quaternary period, Pleistocene and Holocene. It is also called as the recent one. So the first epoch has been started around 76 million years ago. And it was the climatic conditions were the development of the climate belts. Now the different type of climatic belts have started to develop. And when we talk about the plant life, the modernization of angiosperms. Now the angiosperms become more and more modern. Now animal life, evolutionary explosion of mammals. Earlier in the Mesozoic era, the Protherian, Metatherian and Eutherian mammals have been evolved. Now there is a great explosion in the evolution of the mammals. Now this era will be era of the mammals. The second epoch is Eocene. It was around 58 million years ago. Now, in the earlier one, the climatic belts were starting to develop. Now, in this epoch, the climatic belts have been established. The zoned belts have been established in the environment. And the plant life, extinction of angiosperms. That angiosperms that have been arised in the Jurassic period, now they have been extincted. And they were dominant in the Paleocene era, Paleocene epoch. And animal life, placental mammals become diversified and specialized. This was the time of placental mammals, that they become diversified and specialized. Now the third epoch, Oligocene, it was around 39 million years ago, and the climatic conditions were quite warmer at this time. And the plant life is worldwide tropical forest, and the development of monocots and new flowering plants were started. The angiosperms or the flowering plants have been extincted in the Eocene epoch. Now the new flowering plants will now develop in the Oligocene epoch, and the tropical forest now started to develop. And also archaic mammals. When we talk about the animal life, archaic mammals extincted, and now the modern mammals will start to develop. In the Miocene epoch, it was around 28 million years ago. The climate was cool and there was the development of grasses and reduction of the forest. Now the tropical forest, which have been started to develop in the Oligocene era, Oligocene epoch, now they will be extincted and the whole land will be now covered by the grasses. The grasses will become dominant in the next epoch. When we talk about animal life, the mammals at their highest evolution, mammals are now being evolved and the first man-like apes were evolved. What were the first man-like apes? That is the chimpanzees, they were being evolved at that time and it was the only time when the Dryopithecus and Ramapithecus were also being evolved. And during the Oligocene epoch, the Oligopithecus were evolved or Oligopithecus were arised. And in the Miocene epoch, Dryopithecus and Ramapithecus were arises. Now, in the Pliocene era or in the Pliocene epoch, that was around 12 million years ago, the climatic conditions were quite cooler and the forests were declined. That in the Miocene epoch, we talked about the development of the grasses and the reduction of the forest. Forests were starting to reduce. And in the Pliocene epoch, they are now totally declined, they are now totally damaged or destructed. Now the grasses and herbs will become dominant. And when we talk about the animal life, mammals were abundant and the elephants, horses and other mammals were now being evolved. And it was the time when Australopithecus were evolved or arises. Now the second period of the Cenozoic era is the Quaternary period or the another name is the Neogene period that has been divided into the two epochs, that is Pleistocene and Holocene. Pleistocene was around 1 million years ago and it was the period of continental glaciers in the north. Now the glaciers have been started to form in the North Pole and the increment of the herbs. And when we talk about the animal life, age of man and extinction of the large mammals. Large mammals like Oligopithecus, Dryopithecus, Ramapithecus, Caenopithecus and Australopithecus. These were all the robust forms. And now these robust forms are now declined. The large mammals are now declined. Now it is the age of the modern man or the mammals. Now in the Holocene, it was around 0.025 million years ago. Up to this time, the ice age was at the end. This is the end of ice age and the conditions now will become appropriate for the environment. And when we talk about the plant life, the dominance of herbs were become dominant at this time. And this is the age of man, that is the Cro-Magnon and the today's man were appeared in the Holocene epoch. So what we have studied here? We have studied here the last era, that is the Cenozoic, that has been divided into the two periods. What were they? The Tertiary period, it is also called as Paleogene, and the Quaternary period, which is also called as Neogene. The Paleogene has been divided into the five epochs. Paleocene, Eocene, Oligocene, Miocene and Pliocene. When we talk about the first one, that is Paleocene, the plant life is the modernization of the angiosperms. Angiosperms become more and more modern and they were diversified and they were variegated up to this time. And the evolutionary explosion of mammals. The mammals are now being mammals are now being exploded up for the evolution. Earlier the three types of mammals have been evolved: Prototherian, Metatherian and Eutherian. Now the modern mammals will be evolved. And when we talk about the Eocene, that is the second epoch of the Tertiary period of the Cenozoic era, the plant life of the Eocene epoch is extinction of the angiosperms. Angiosperms has now been extincted and the placental mammals were diversified and the specialized. In the Oligocene epoch, the climatic conditions were quite warmer and the worldwide tropical forests were diversified. At this time, the tropical forests were at their abundant and the development of the monocots and new type of flowering plants like herbs and the shrubs, they have been found in the environment. They have been arising in the environment. And the archaic mammals were extincted and the modern mammals now arises in the Oligocene epoch. What was the first modern mammal? Oligopithecus, that have been arised in the Oligocene. Oligocene, Oligopithecus has been arrived. And when we talk about the Miocene, there is in the, when we talk about the plant life of the Miocene, there is the development of the grasses and declination or the reduction of the tropical forest. And when we talk about the animal life, mammals are their higher rate of the evolution. And the first man-like ape, that is the chimpanzees, were appeared, and it was the era or it was the epoch when the Dryopithecus and the Ramapithecus were also has been arised. When we talk about the Pliocene, the decline of the forest, here in the plant life the forest started to decline and the herbs and the shrubs were at their dominant stage and the mammals were abundant and the other type of mammals like elephants and horses, they have also been arrived or arises at the Pliocene epoch. Now when we talk about the second period, that is the Quaternary period, which is also called as the Neogene, there are the two epochs in the Neogene period. Which were they? Pleistocene and the Holocene. The first one is Pleistocene, which was around 1 million years ago, and it is the period when the herbs were at their dominant condition and the Australopithecus, it is the age of man. The Australopithecus, the Ramapithecus and the Dryopithecus, Oligopithecus, all these animals were extincted up to this time. And now from here the modern mammals have been evolved, that is Homo erectus, Homo sapiens have been evolved, which were more cultured and more civilized. From this epoch the civilization also started in the human evolution. The last one, that is the Holocene, it is the end of ice age and the climate were become more warmer, that is appropriate climatic conditions were evolved in the environment. And this was the period of, or this was the epoch of dominance of the herbs, and the modern man, Cro-Magnon and the today's man has been arrived in the Holocene era or Holocene epoch of the Quaternary or the Neogene period of the Cenozoic era. Now we have completed the geological time scale and from this we have also completed our evolution. Now we will look after towards the questionaries.